Quasi hopa, gaita which a shak, douche the megash beach set, the jammy hunnel zest, a gash brak shutun washti, ishkawa agume et the Miamista. Hello everyone, my name is Tania Garcia and I am from the Santa Ana in Acoma Pueblo in New Mexico. I will be reading the land acknowledgement for you this evening. Lawrence University's Appleton and Door County campuses are located on the ancestral homelands of the Menominee Nation, or what they call themselves the Mamacheta. Currently, there are 11 federally recognized Native American sovereign nations in Wisconsin. We acknowledge these indigenous communities who have stewarded this land throughout the generations, and we pay respect to their elders past and present. Gawae, thank you.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the virtual Be the Light Happy Hour event. I hope you're well. My name is Charlotte Nelson Singleton, and I'm from the class of 1967, and I have the privilege of being one of the tri-chairs for the Be the Light campaign committee.
My name is Corey Nettles. I'm from the class of 1992, and with Char, I also am one of the tri-chairs of the Be the Light campaign committee, and I also have the distinct pleasure of being the current vice chair of the Board of Trustees.
And I'm Dave Blowers from the class of 1982. And with Char and Corey, I have the pleasure of being a tri-chair of the Be the Light campaign and the privilege of serving as the board chair of the Board of Trustees.
So we'd like to welcome you and thank you for attending probably the first ever happy hour event. And in this case, it's tied to our Be the Light campaign. So we're thrilled that you're here.
And we'd like to thank Mark Burstein, our president and CEO, for our university president, I always say CEO, for his leadership during this transformational campaign on behalf of Lawrence.
And we'd like to thank each of you who have already supported the Be the Light campaign and the Lawrence Fund.
Welcome, Lawrence family. It's such a pleasure to be with you all tonight. I crave time with Downerites, Lawrentians, and also friends of the college. It's just great to be with you all and to be with you all at a moment where we can celebrate Lawrence and the success of the Be the Light campaign. We've had so much success thanks to support from so many, and that success has really propelled our four areas of investment: the Lawrence Fund, Full Speed to Full Need, the student journey, and campus renewal. So thank you so much for joining us tonight. At each event across the country, which I've had the pleasure to be at during this campaign, there's always been someone who's gotten up and talked about a statement, what we called the Because of Lawrence statement, how Lawrence has changed their lives. I've never been asked to give a Because of Lawrence statement. And it's interesting tonight, as I think about my last year as a president, to think about what Because of Lawrence means to me. Because of Lawrence, I have learned so much as a human, as a leader, as someone who cares deeply about education. But I think at the core for me, I've learned about what community is, how it works, how important it is for each of us to really thrive as individuals and to reach our full potential. Tonight, we have a really exciting program in store for all of us, a way to celebrate both the impact the campaign has already had and the promise, the future of the campaign on this campus. We'll start off with a discussion, presentation from students, and others about how Full Speed to Full Need impacts their lives. And I see that every day on this campus, talking to students and seeing how our financial support has made their education possible. We'll then go to the Science Learning Commons, a really extraordinary investment in this institution, which will allow us to rewrite, redesign every introductory science course. I will say that as a non-science major, I would have really benefited from a redesigned introductory science class. Maybe it would have allowed me to stay as a biology major, something I thought I was going to be when I started out in college. Then we have a very exciting announcement about Bjorklunden, a project that is one that's very close to my heart. And then we'll end with a conversation about the impact of the Lawrence Fund. Of course, today is Giving Day, so how could we not end without talking about the Lawrence Fund and its impact on every aspect of this campus? Every day, the Lawrence Fund is our secret sauce. It makes it all happen. But I'm sure with your invitation, you saw that you got a recipe for what we call the BTL. I have one right here with me. So please, if you can, take time, if you haven't already, to mix your own drink so we can all drink together, drink to Lawrence, and for all your support of this beautiful enterprise. Cheers.
We are scientists and artists.
Writers, athletes, explorers, and musicians. We are first-generation college students and lifetime learners.
We're leaders and friends, colleagues and activists.
We come from coast to coast, big cities and small towns.
We dream of playing on famous stages, healing the sick, inspiring the next generation, and changing the world. We are
Lawrentians. Since 2016, Full Speed to Full Need has made the Lawrence experience possible for hundreds of students.
And that is just the beginning.
Hello, everyone. My name is Marley Matthews. I'm an incoming sophomore at Lawrence, and I'm an oboe performance major in the con. And because of Lawrence, I can not only study music, but I can explore my interests outside of music as well.
Hello, my name is Quentin Giglio, and I'm in the 3-2 engineering program at Lawrence University. And because of the support that I've received, I was able to spend this past summer researching copper bowls and X-ray diffraction. I'm very excited to return to Lawrence in the fall and continue to follow my dreams to become a physicist and an engineer, and none of that would be possible without the constant and enthusiastic support that I received from the university.
When I was in high school, I felt really underprepared academically. But because of the wonderful staff and my support system here at Lawrence, I will be the first person in my family to graduate from college.
Hello, my name is Ladora Thomas. I'm a sophomore studying government here at Lawrence. And because of Lawrence, I've been exposed to so many new leadership opportunities through our Lawrence University Community Council, the student government here on campus. Without that, I would not be able to say that I'm currently the public relations secretary for the 2020-2021 school year.
I'm Catherine Gunther-Kodat, Provost and Dean of the Faculty, and it's my great pleasure to welcome you to our virtual Be the Light campaign event. Of course, I would much rather be with all of you personally, but until that great day arrives, we're just going to have to let technology work its magic for us. When I came to Lawrence in fall of 2017, Be the Light was still in its silent phase. But the wonderful work that it would make possible was already making itself felt. Thanks to Gifts in Hand, we have been able to appoint a senior faculty member to an endowed position in East Asian Studies. We've been able to mount searches for new faculty in organizational psychology and cognitive neuroscience. And we've been able to support curricular revisions that bring fresh, cutting-edge approaches to teaching and learning. The liberal arts approach to undergraduate education has always been about combining the best in tradition and innovation, and curricular renewal is a key aspect of that work. An extremely exciting example of this that you're going to be hearing more about today is the revision to our entry-level courses in biology, chemistry, and physics that we've been able to undertake thanks to a $1 million Inclusive Excellence Grant from the Howard Hughes Medical Institute. The HHMI describes the Inclusive Excellence Initiative as a challenge, and I'm going to quote them here, to U.S. colleges and universities to substantially and sustainably increase their capacity for inclusion of all students, especially those students who belong to groups underrepresented in science, close quote. Lawrence's faculty have answered the call and taken up that challenge, embarking on top-to-bottom curricular renovation in first-year courses that take an interactive approach to the material and emphasize creativity and collaboration. The HHMI grant helps us cover the costs of faculty workshops and retreats to develop the curriculum. It's also allowed us to hire visiting faculty who specialize in inclusive curricular redesign. A critical aspect of this project, and one whose costs are not covered by the grant, is the creation of the Science Learning Commons, a completely re-envisioned instructional space that will allow our faculty to make their dreams come true. Now, to share with you some of the exciting details of this project, I'm delighted to introduce you to Associate Professor of Chemistry, Stefan Debrett. Stefan is the principal investigator for the HHMI grant, and he has been the driving force in Lawrence's curricular innovation in the sciences. Joining him is senior biochemistry major Kelly Vences, who will give firsthand insights into how opportunities for collaboration and connection are transforming the study of the sciences for students here at Lawrence University. So take it away, Stefan and Kelly.
Here at Lawrence, it's important to all of us that every student that walks through our doors receives an effective, immersive, life-changing education. For those of us in the Natural Science Division, that means that our classes should help students find the same amazement and joy that we find in the physical world around us. In 2020, we're reminded again and again that we have work to do to achieve a more equitable society and a more equitable Lawrence. A few years ago, this concern led us to seek and obtain a five-year, $1 million inclusive excellence grant from the Howard Hughes Medical Institute. This support is helping us identify and dismantle barriers to success that are faced by our students, particularly our first-generation college students and our students of color. One of these barriers might be the structure of some of our classes. For better or worse, many of us are now acquainted with the Zoom lecture. A lecture can convey information, but it's less effective at building the inquiry and critical thinking skills that scientists need. Moreover, lectures can leave students feeling disconnected from the class and from their classmates as they simply sit back and watch. The thing is, that disengagement really isn't a Zoom problem. It's a lecture problem. This is Young Child 121. If you're an alum, you might remember this room from your own Lawrence experience. When I teach a large introductory chemistry class in this room by lecturing, it can be difficult to get students to engage with the material and to engage with each other as they develop their problem-solving skills. We need a better way to teach and spaces that can support more effective pedagogy. Active learning rooms like this one can facilitate more effective teaching. Small groups, multiple displays, accessible to all. We know this works, and we want to bring this experience to our large introductory courses in biology, chemistry, and physics. These courses provide crucial foundations for our students beginning their science training. We need these classes to unreservedly welcome, thoughtfully engage, and effectively teach every student, and we need a space that can facilitate this kind of impactful pedagogy. Our vision is a science commons designed with inclusion as a guiding principle that can facilitate group problem solving with seamless sharing of data. We're excited about what this space will allow us to accomplish with our students. We're laying the groundwork for a more welcoming and a more effective science curriculum that can help every student find success.
My name is Kelly Vences, and I am a senior at Lawrence University. I study chemistry and biochemistry. Over the past 4 years, I've been able to do about 2 years of research as a Lawrence University research fellow, which is a very exciting opportunity presented to like some students to be able to do summer research. With the summer research, I've been able to work with Professor Sazima, like directly under him, just working with a bunch of other peers. Through this research, I've been able to build myself as a scientist and also be able to present my research. And I was not only able to present it to my Lawrence University community here, but I was also able to present it to other different universities around the Midwest. And that's where we were able to travel and present. My personal favorite was this past summer, where I was able to present a poster at a Latinx Twitter conference, which is an international conference. So I have not only been able to reach like my community here, but also internationally, where I have been like recognized at this point, which is a very exciting opportunity as a scientist, because I want to be able to present my research and my work to people, not just in this scientific community, but everywhere else in the world. And that's an opportunity given to me by being a research fellow here at Lawrence, which is very unique to Lawrence University. And thanks to donor support, we are able to fund even more and expand to different fields and then to different like students that don't really get the opportunities to do these research activities and projects anywhere else. And I'm very thankful.
When I first heard about the Science Learning Commons project, I thought, that is a project I can get behind. I spent many hours in Young Child 161, which is now 121, listening to lectures in chemistry, sometimes in biology, but there were times I remember dozing off, falling asleep, because lectures can be dry. So I went on to get an education in chemical engineering, went on and worked in business in research and development, but I've always considered my foundation of science education at Lawrence to be the key to my success. And so I'm forever grateful for that education. But let's all come together and now and ensure that the Science Learning Commons is a success. I challenge all science majors to contribute to ensure that we have the funds necessary for this renovation. To that end, I will be matching those contributions one for one to a maximum of $100,000. Let's ensure this happens. So I raise my glass to toast the future of science at Lawrence University.
Because of Lawrence, I learned the value of living authentically, and that only by pushing yourself to your limits can those limits be stretched.
Because of Lawrence, 50 years later, following graduation, I am still able to recite the entire Samuel T. Coleridge poem, The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, and that's rhyme, R-I-M-E. Thank you, Freshman Studies.
Because of Lawrence, I'm a musician who can also write.
Because of Lawrence, I truly learned how to think critically and honestly, which has helped me thrive in my career in radio broadcasting and journalism. Lawrence played a pivotal role in developing my thirst for knowledge, and that pushes me to ask probing questions and hunt for answers. I uncover stories that not only inform listeners, but help them understand the true heart inside events happening in their community. And while I strive to provide my listeners the critical information they need every day, I do so by remembering our university's motto, light, more light.
Because of Lawrence, I learned a little bit about everything and how to learn more. My whole life was transformed, and I am grateful for the friends I made.
Hi, my name is Tom Paulson, Lawrence class of 93, and I'm standing in the beautiful great room at Bjorklunden, Lawrence's northern campus. This campus holds a very special connection to our family. We all remember the seminars and the restorative effect that they had up at Bjorklunden. As adult learners, we continue to come to Bjorklunden to learn and to reconnect with our alumni. And as now residents of Door County, Mary and I enjoy the trails and the culture that this campus brings to us. So we're excited today to announce a very interesting project that we've been working on with Lawrence University. Back in early 2000, Faith Technologies was contracted to do an engineering study to determine the feasibility and the cost of making this campus carbon neutral. The results of that study came back in June, and it turns out that we can do it through upgrades in lighting, heating and cooling systems, an upgrade to our existing wind turbine, an installation of a solar field, and also some geothermal systems, we can make this entire campus carbon neutral and also have this campus become a living, breathing laboratory for today's students and attract future students to this unique property. The Paulson family is extremely excited to announce that we will be matching $800,000 of this $1.6 million project. So please join us in support of this wonderful project to make this campus carbon neutral for ourselves, for future generations, as we all become better stewards of the environment.
Because of Lawrence, I got to experience their northern campus here in beautiful Door County, Wisconsin, called Bjorklunden. It was a welcomed escape for college students to come up and get away from the hustle and bustle of campus life. From class trips to group bonfires to exploring nature, this helped to give me a well-rounded liberal arts education. And for me, I loved it so much, I came back and married my LU partner here on these very grounds.
Hi, my name is Jason Bernheimer, and I'm a junior here at Lawrence majoring in global studies. Because of Lawrence's northern campus in Door County, Wisconsin, Bjorklunden, I've been able to gain a better appreciation for my natural surroundings, as well as relax and rejuvenate and build community with my fellow Lawrentians.
Because of Lawrence, my husband Rob and I are lifelong learners, like most Lawrentians. Thanks to Bjorklunden, we've been able to travel to Cuba and to visit the London Center and the sites of London. Here at Bjorklunden, we have learned so much from seminars, everything from woods in the morning and wine in the afternoon to Putin's Russia. It's an amazing range of topics.
Hello all, my name is Alba John. I am a senior here at Lawrence University, majoring in government and minoring in ethnic studies. I'm excited to talk to you about the Lawrence Fund. The Lawrence Fund is a critical part of the Be the Light campaign. Well, what is the Lawrence Fund? The Lawrence Fund is the university's annual fund with 100% of the gifts going towards immediate student needs. From a student's perspective, the Lawrence Fund goes towards the conservatory, athletics, conducting research with professors, being able to study abroad. Without the Lawrence Fund, students would not be able to do all the amazing things we get to do.
Hi, this is Hung. I'm a senior from Vietnam. My major is piano performance, and I also have a minor in anthropology. So thanks to Lawrence, I've had access to a wonderful liberal arts education where I've made so many precious connections with so many amazing people. And last but not least, I can always be myself here.
Hi, my name is Rochelle, and I am a sophomore at Lawrence University. And right now I am undecided, but I am interested in psychology. And because of Lawrence, I was able to receive an emergency grant fund due to COVID and everything, and it just really helped me with a lot of the funds that I needed to cover. And yeah.
I'm Annalisa Dietemar, and I study theater and history at Lawrence. Because of Lawrence, I discovered my voice and my purpose, and I develop lifelong friendships with mentors and friends across the globe.
Hi, my name is Mia. I am a sophomore first-generation Hispanic student from New York. I am on a pre-med track studying neuroscience and ethnic studies, and I'm also a part of Colores and Alianza, which are my two favorite communities on campus. And it's because of you and because of Lawrence that I can excitedly pursue my passions and get the education I need to work towards the future that I want. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Malcolm Davis. I'm a second year percussion and government double degree major. Because of Lawrence, I could study at a conservatory while also receiving a valuable liberal arts education.
First class from Milwaukee Downer to Lawrence. Extraordinary experience in both schools. I think certainly Lawrence catapulted me into my world of theater and ultimately television, where I have remained and still work at the age of 77. So thank you, Lawrence. It's fantastic.
Hi, my name is Jessica Hopkins. I'm a junior religious studies major at Lawrence. And this past spring, when I was studying abroad in Greece and COVID-19 came, because of Lawrence, I was able to safely and without much financial impact to my family, get home in a timely manner.
I was able to attend Lawrence because of the generosity of people just like you who together make this high-quality, life-changing education possible. And because I was taught these critical thinking skills at Lawrence, I can successfully run a 100-person newsroom at a time when local news has never been more important.
Because of Lawrence, I was able to study abroad in England last winter term, and I had such a life-changing experience. Giving Day is a key component to helping us finish the Be the Light campaign strong and raising gifts for the Lawrence Fund. Today is the only day you get to take part in the Game Changer Challenges. If you are in the classes of 2004-2024, your donation gets matched with $500. So $10 quickly becomes $510. And for everyone else, your donation gets matched dollar to dollar, so it doubles. So please do not forget to donate today. And to everyone who's already donated, thank you so much for all your support. It means so much. And now, enjoy this performance from the Horn Studio.
Komt toch erbij, Jäger Tribe, komt toch erbij, komt toch erbij, SM geeft jetzt. Erbsen super, mietet en Schweinebach, Erbsen super, Schnaps gibt's es auch. Halali, halali.
Lawrentians around the world wake up, ready to chase the light of a new day. We are from different countries, different backgrounds, different traditions. But we are united by a desire to explore the unknown, unusual, unfamiliar. Labs are booted up. Lamps are placed on great works. The same sun shines over Lawrentians at Bjorklanden, the London Center, and Appleton. A path is illuminated for curious, unique individuals who prefer to blaze their own trail. Students and professors work closely in innovative programs, illuminating our minds and elevating our humanity. Athletes walk onto the field, and performers take to the stage, preparing for our moment to shine. Lawrentians are part of a global community, a legacy of lifelong learners, prepared to succeed in a rapidly changing world. We're leading global enterprises, improving world health, and teaching the next generation to pay it forward. Creating new opportunities for students to shine, we're on a mission to spread our light far and wide. Because the world needs learners. The world needs leaders. The world needs Lawrentians.
We really hope that you will consider supporting one of the campaign priorities and make your gift between now and December 30th. We hope you will join us.
And in anticipation of those gifts between now and 12:30, let's celebrate the success that we've had already. So we hope that you will join us in doing that.
And in a hearty Lawrence way, here's to meeting and exceeding our goals for the Be the Light campaign by the end of 2020. Cheers to everybody. Thank you.
Cheers.
Salud.